think with all this white noise around me, surrounding me, trying to figure out where my groundings be. With all this black and white and wrong and right, I'm trying to find the ground between, the brown between. See, at these depths, you might find seaweed. Defining the difference between me, my identity, and how they see me. But when I feel that pressure pressed up on my neck, I can't breathe, see? Feel like I'm pressing my back against that green screen. See, the black lives really matter, or is this scene just on repeat? Either validate them and they be on their way, or they stay sleeping, because that's where the sweet dreams lay.
Let me just tell you a little bit about life, real quick. You got to slow down, you got to breathe. It's not mechanical. You know what? I had a girlfriend, and I couldn't believe it. She played, just hold on, listen to this. So one day, we decided just to jam. I had the drum, and she had the keyboard, and we were just going to jam, have a good time, right? And I said, play something, I was going to play along with her. But she couldn't play anything. She said, I need music. And I thought she was joking, right? So what I realized later, she learned music backwards. So if a teacher is teaching you how to read music first and you're not enjoying yourself, that's backwards. That's backwards. When I was a little kid, about 16, I had drums, but I never thought I would be doing this. And I fooled around, but back east, there was no teacher. So when I got here, I took lessons from Louis Conti. He was a wonderful drummer. Took lessons for about a year and a half. And I got there one day, and I knew something wasn't right because he met me at the door and he said, I can't teach you anymore. And it broke my heart. But he said, no, it's a good thing. And I said, what do you mean? He said, I gave you all I have. It's time for you to go out and explore and bring me something back. So that's what I did. I went out and I just did all my other thing. I worked with an African drum group, and then I realized I have my own stuff. I'm not African, you know. I got it in my blood, but I play my own stuff. Same thing with you. Nobody, there's no two people that talk alike. There's no people that look alike. There's no two people that think alike. I will never be able to play like some of the other people, so I don't, right? Can you just hold on for a second?
All right,
just,
yeah.
Just hold on one second. Hold on, just one second. You know, I don't know why I'm giving this to you, but I think this will help you. Can you take it?
You sure?
Yeah, take that. If you ever see me again, let me know what you think. But when you go down there and you catch that bus, don't run, walk, and take your time. If you miss it, another one's coming.
All right.
Life's the same way. Where are you rushing to? To die? No, take your time. I'll see you later.
All right, my brother, I appreciate it. I'm walking.
Be safe. There you go.
Did you forget? Forget about the music within the mountain? The tune your feet play in the frozen morning while you etch notes onto the bare brown hips of the range? Didn't you feel the rhythm of the wilderness while you rested on the rocky shoulder? The beat of rockfall reverberating off the canyon walls. And when you reached the peak, did you remember that the wind sang as it blew through lava and rock and ice? Sang so hard it cracked the mountain and shattered the slope, sending a crescendo into the valley below? And when you decided to turn back, as you clicked into your skis and tapped your poles and stomped your feet, didn't you feel the jazz? The swing in your hips each turn and the slash in the left and the right and the drop and the jump? The syncopation of each pole plan and powder cloud and hoot and howl. And when you look back, didn't you see the piece you played improvised on the peak's paper flanks? Miles, Monk, Fitzgerald, James, Blakely, Holiday, Coltrane. Don't you remember the music within the mountain?
Forget about the music within the mountain, the tune your feet played in the frozen morning while you etched notes onto the bare brown hips of the range. Didn't you feel the rhythm of the wilderness while you rested on a rocky shoulder, the beat of rockfall reverberating off the canyon walls? As you clicked into your skis and tapped your poles and stomped your feet, didn't you feel the jazz? The swing in your hips to each turn and slash and right and left and drop and jump. The syncopation of each pole, plant, and powder cloud, and hoot and howl. And when you looked back, didn't you see the piece you played? Improvised on the peak's paper flanks? Miles and Monk, Fitzgerald, James, Blakely, Holiday, and Coltrane. Don't you remember? The music within the mountain.